call her out is Hendrix. I promise you, swag, swag. You know that, bitch? Yo. Percocet, Miley Percocet. Percocet, Miley Percocet. Represent, gotta represent. Chase a chick, never chase a bitch.
Chase no bitch.
Mask on, fuck it, mask on. Mask on, fuck it, mask on.
Yo, what's up, everybody? How y'all doing today, man? First thing first, thank you for your love and your support. I highly appreciate it. Can't express it enough. Real talk, real shit. So y'all already know, man, before I start this video, I would love to thank everybody for showing mad love and support. Like I said, man, it's always important to make sure you always thank everybody for continuously showing mad love and support. You know, I really, really, really appreciate it every step of the way. If you're new to my channel, I highly recommend you watching this video with somebody. And please understand, this is my opinion based off my research, okay? And I highly recommend everybody to do their own research, okay? So what y'all looking at, man, it's your girl, your man, Jackie O, okay? And again, I know this rub a lot of people the wrong way, you know what I'm saying? Because a lot of y'all believe that this is true, you know what I mean? And again, I get it. At first, I didn't get it, you know? I was going around arguing with trolls. I was going around calling people trolls, but I get it. You know, we were programmed from birth to believe whatever they throw at us. So I can't get mad at people or upset with people because they're fighting for these celebrities. You know, they're acting like these celebrities is their family. You know what I'm saying? But I get it. I just want y'all to understand that I get it. Okay. So just to add on to it, y'all, like I told y'all, man, these characters they create from scratch. Okay. All of these characters was created to help push agenda, right? And at the end of the day, one of the number one agendas they want to push is fear. Fear tactics, fear porn, to make us scared. If you can have America / the world fear and scared, you can control us. And you have to have control. In order to do that, you have to gravitate to people, right? Different culture, different races, different genders, right? And you do that by building a celebrity, right? Because if you're trying to push something, it's easy to push something when your favorite star / celebrity is doing it, okay? Now, like I was saying, man, one thing about these celebrities, right, before they exit off the world stage, they're always subliminal with their pictures, right? So one of her last pictures she posted, right, it looks like she's at a funeral, right? Black and white, and y'all already know about the black and white duality. And if y'all don't know about it, I made a 35-minute video I'm going to be dropping really soon explaining about it, okay? But every time these celebrities die, notice how their last pictures always be black and white. Even some celebrities like Prince posted just a black post, okay? But I want y'all to understand that, okay? And then they also start, like, how can I say it, y'all, from this last post right here? They also start pretty much begging and pleading, like, you know? And again, I felt like this post right here was very subliminal, you know? It said, when you start drawing near to God, reading and really listening to the word and applying it in real life, there's such a beautiful awakening and transforming power that you start to feel. And I just really love that for me and also from all my loved ones that are really experiencing it as well. Every conversation I had lately has God all up in it. And he really has the answer to every single thing. God is so dope. Laugh out loud. Emojis. Love y'all. All Jackie. Okay. Now, do y'all see how subliminal this message is, and do y'all see how subliminal these messages be, right? So you got to ask yourself, right, one question, right? If you know you made a deal with the devil, you sacrificed your soul, right? And you know any day now they're going to kill you, right? What would you really do, right? You will start begging and pleading for your life, right? You will probably start telling every secret there was because you're like, hey, what I got to lose and stuff like that, right? That's what you'll start doing, right? But when you write messages like this, this is clearly somebody just not begging and pleading for their life, right? With laughing emojis, right? Meaning that she has some type of understanding that her character will be killed off the world stage, okay? There will be another character for her later in the world stage, okay? You remember, y'all, they're not regular people like us, okay? They don't go home like us. They don't use a restroom like us. They don't have souls like us that will actually care about somebody. They don't care. They can give two fucks about you. If you were standing in their face, you were standing right in front of them, they wouldn't give you the time of day. They don't care, y'all. They're not like us, okay? They appear like us. They look like us, but they're not us, okay? They literally not, okay? And I want y'all to understand that. She was clearly mocking God. She was clearly mocking fun of what's about to happen, okay? And just like I showed y'all, you know, yesterday with DC Young Fly already, you know, admitted pretty much to sacrificing her, right? Because this is the narrative they want to push to us. You know what I'm saying? And again, y'all, if you look at this picture right here, this picture, y'all, is so telling, okay? It's not just the fact, y'all, that they got black and white duality, right? That's also one huge thing, right? But if this picture also looks like this is somebody's funeral, right? You know what I'm saying? And when you look at it, too, this little girl's shoes, she clearly has on, appear to be her mother or somebody else's shoes, right? Because these shoes does not fit this little girl. Also, what stroller is this for, right? You know what I mean? Because none of these kids can fit inside of that stroller, y'all. So you just bark this picture, this stroller to take a picture? It just makes no sense at all, okay? It makes absolutely no sense at all. I told y'all, and I'm going to tell y'all again, man, you know, YouTube is very sensitive, you know? So we don't never know when YouTube is going to cut the plug on somebody's channel, delete people's videos. So I highly recommend everybody to save all the videos you can. I want everybody to wake up. You know, we living in the fairy tale world, and it's not you guys' fault. Question everything, okay? Question everything, okay? You know what I'm saying? Question everything. Now, on the other end, this guy, DC Young Fly, right, really believe by sacrificing, allegedly, his wife, right, that he's going to get his own TV show. He already got an album coming out, and he already got a song he's about to drop. Aiming at his wife, talking about his wife, how he missed her and stuff. Now, y'all got to answer yourself one question, right? Ask yourself one question, right? What the fuck is that about, y'all? You know what I'm saying? Because I'm going to tell you, when he dropped that song, the numbers is going to go off the roof, right? The streams are going to go off the roof, right? The video for that is going to go off the roof, right? So he's probably set to make $2 or $3 million off a song about his wife passing. Okay, that's going to set him up with a podcast deal and also a TV show deal. Okay, he was very subliminal about taking why he did not take Nick Cannon's job for Wild and Out. Okay, which makes no sense at all, because now Nick Cannon is taking Jamie Foxx's job. Y'all got to pay attention to that. Okay, so in the back of his mind, this is what he's thinking, y'all. These are what these puppets do. Okay, once you sell your soul, know that's it. You know what I'm saying? No, that's it, man. When you sell your soul, that's it. You know what I mean? Don't listen to nothing these people tell you. They go promise you every and anything. You know what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, ain't nothing guaranteed to you. Ain't nothing owed to you. And ain't nothing promised to you. You know what I'm saying? And that's just some real shit. Don't fall victim to this shit. You know what I'm saying? Don't do it. These people are misleading you guys on purpose to damage your family, to damage your faith, to damage your hope, to damage who you are, to keep you informed, to be scared. Live your life to the fullest, y'all. Okay? With that being said, man, much love and respect to everybody. Me, y'all have a good day.